What's your favorite beer so far?
Celebration at Shoreline.
Shoreline?
Yes, the 2009 Celebration. It's a barley wine. It was amazing.
Really, as far as Indiana beer, you got Flat 12, you got Sun King, and you got beer.
Very
some
cool.
Of the better ones.
Great Crescent. She makes these fantastic fans. Best part of the festival. Love her.
I asked for one. I didn't give them out.
Smart.
Next festival I go to, I'm making these. Everyone's like,
you can go on your phone and
they put it on the back too.
Oh, I know. She's good.
The website.
Guys,
she's good.
On the back? Oh. Smart.
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 Out of the whole like canning movement that's becoming really popular. You're seeing more and more in cans, and there's actually a canned beer festival. I have to ask, are you for cans or bottles? Go further, a solo cup.
I think solo cup, without a doubt, I like it when it's glass. The good thing about the Summer Beer Festival is that they give you glass samples.
Wish I was cheaper.
Okay, nice.
I like bottles.
Bottles.
I like cans.
Okay, ooh.
Cans, the aluminum affects the flavor. I like it.
I think bottle caps affect flavor of bottles.
You know, New Belgium, they started canning recently. Apparently, their cans are a little bit more expensive than you can get a six-pack of beer.
I agree.
So I go glass bottles over canning so much.
You know, if I was to choose beer, I like beer that's on tap. Don't like bottle or can.
So this makes the bottle versus cans debate relatively irrelevant. I don't care what it comes in, as long as I can pour it into a glass.
Nice.
That is the most profound answer that I'll ever hear about the bottle versus can movement.
People are waiting for an answer like that.
Most people have been waiting for me.
I'm glad I found you. You're a treasure.
Yeah, I am a treasure.
Do you get hangovers quite often, or is it just
about every weekend? Name your
own sleep.
Sleep. Wow. Sleep.
Maybe that's
sleep.
What I need to start doing is sleeping more.
Yeah.
Are you trying to get him to take his shirt off?
Well,
Drinker's gone wild.
He said he'd only do it if you did.
Yeah, right.
Sorry. That's it. We're asking questions.
Yeah, I set myself up for that one.
Yeah. Listen, what's your hangover cure?
I don't get hungover.
Sadly, I'm one of those people that you don't get hangovers.
Blue Gatorade.
Mine is vitamin water 120.
Okay. Now, I have to ask, why blue Gatorade? Because mine's green Gatorade.
Maybe it's just partial to the person.
Yeah, very true.
Eggs and more eggs.
What?
Oh!
Very cool. What's your hangover cure?
Time. That's about it. Time and water.
My sister's mother-in-law, very devout Catholic, sent me some oyster crackers. Between that and the Gatorade, born again, ready to go start drinking again.
You drink like a mimosa or something, you're fine.
Nice.
This guy.
Good as gold.
This guy.
Cheers. Yeah.
Sir.
Dude, this is the coolest t-shirt I've seen here. You might have had to get a picture.
I want one too.
Everybody say slut.
Are you ready? 3, 2, 1.
Slut!
Come on down on my little cabin. Ain't nobody there but me. Come on down on my little cabin. Ain't so full, you see. I got a cooking there, cooking collard green. Put his women you most ever seen. Come on down on my little cabin. Ain't nobody there but me. Ain't nobody there but me.
Yeah, the crap's coming in. An hour is good while it lasted. Clay, what type is the Double Fog?
Double Fog is a Belgian quadruple. And one is a gold medal
at the World Beer Cup in 2012.
Excellent.
Very cool.
Yeah, so Belgium. I remember is this year.
Yes. And here we go. Upland. I love you guys.
So it's our reserve. We're having the opening party on Sunday.
Oh, very cool.
We've already brewed Oktoberfest and Pilsner over there.
All right.
So we moved all the tanks in this week. We've been just cleaning all week. Come around back and get the blackberry. That's my favorite of the
blackberry?
The fruit ones right now.
Very cool.
The Dantillion, we've only got one case left, and this is it.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So you're going to have to get in line several times.
Do you mind if I do
just
that?
Just stick around. And the art on the Dantillion is fantastic, too.
No way.
Very nice.
Norton Wisdom.
I'll say, actually, I'm an artist myself.
Yeah?
Let me give you an action shot.
Cool.
Beer.
Let's see.
For the VIPs, we have our Batch 100 Russian Imperial Stout, the Captain Blackstrap.
Okay, we're going for that.
Yeah, we'll roll it back out towards the end. It's on for the VIP hour.
There you are.
Thank you.
Brewed with Blackstrap molasses.
Awesome.
Yeah, smoke malt, honey malt, oats, a few different caramels, some caramunic.
How you doing?
Good, how are you?
Good.
So it's kind of a loaded up Imperial Stout.
Yeah.
It's loaded.
1% blackstrap molasses, which really comes through in it. It's almost like a licorice.
Yeah, Damien is our Belgian Golden Strong. So it's got a little sugar in the boil, so it's a little sugary, sweet flavor. And it's a little spicy from the Belgian yeast we use. It's a Trappist ale yeast. It has saffir hops, it's S-A-P-H-I-R, saffir, it's a New Zealand hop, and some German Hirschberger hops in it. 8.4% alcohol.
Yep. Very nice.
Schwartz is the middle one, right?
It is.
So I gotta get in the groove here.
What's the fourth one? Empty?
It's, yeah, it was gonna be water for us, and then the keg is not functioning. So. Oh.
The water keg isn't functioning?
There's a leak in it.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that.
Now we brought some extra bottles. About 3 months. It's not a whole lot. We've only been open for 5, so.
Oh, wow.
It's pretty new.
It's good Schwartz beer.
Oh, thank you. Yeah. I'm not a big wheat guy. I'm not a big light beer guy, but I think I drink that all the time, especially when I'm brewing because it's too damn hot.
Are you the brewer?
I'm one of the 5.
Oh.
All the owners are brewers there, too.
Yeah.
I would say that one is like closest to our homebrew version of anything we've made so far. Just exactly how we wanted it to turn out.
Hey, behind you. I need it from the master. Thank you.
Master Vader? No, I have an injury. I'm out of the game. She's out of town for a month, and this is what I get. Yeah.
Oh!
The exact opposite. They got 3 drinkable ones, but all their specialty ones are like, oh, you guys need to go back to the drawing board.
So you have a bit, so you guys live around Cincinnati, Kentucky area. You've been to the
Moreline Lagerhouse.
Yeah. Awesome.
I swear by that place.
That place is awesome.
Oh my God.
I will always stand by the
their pork belly.
If you don't mind.
It's fine.
Hey,
cool.
If you go there, the pork
actually,
I don't want to cuss a lot.
I had
don't worry, actually.
You're saying anything racist.
I will cut that out.
There's some meat on top of the
okay, well, here, I'll do it. So wait a second. If you have a Mexican maid and you tell her to clean things spick and span, is that racist? There we go.
It's just a figure of speech.
Exactly.
Given she can speak English, but see, no, that's racist.
I was like,
what's it taste like?
Vinegar.
So you don't like sour beer at all?
No, I don't.
Okay.
Tart. I can do tart, not sour.
Well, what's the flavor difference for you? Because to me, this tastes tart. Tastes like a sweet tart.
Yeah, I guess. I don't know. Obviously, I haven't had enough of them to distinguish, but I don't. There's some beers I'd like that are kind of sour, and there's some that are just over the top.
Is this the first sour you ever finish?
Yeah, probably. I think it is. It's actually a really good sour, I'll be honest. It's Sun King Stupid Sexy Flanders.
So why is this sour different from other beers?
I don't know. There's a malt backbone that kind of came through in the end, and I enjoyed it. I don't know why it's different.
Tony's what we call an angry drunk.
I bought tickets to the Patriots.
He's gonna hit me.
You know what? I bought
the I'm on down on my low cabin. Ain't a bird there but me. I'm on down on my low cabin, baby. Ain't so for you, see. Cook's in the kitchen, cooking a little ham. She don't get no, we don't give her. I'm on down on my low cabin.
It was great. It was really awesome. It's always awesome. I will come back next year again.
It's been an embarrassment since I was growing up. Embarrassment now. Embarrassment in the future. My birth was an embarrassment.
Come on down to my low cabin. Anybody's ever been. Come on down to my low cabin. Ain't so for you, see. I'll have a little fist if it'll go to your head. Climb back to cover and you can go to bed. Come on down to my low cabin. Anybody die with me, I mean. Anybody die with me. Come on down to my low cabin, baby. And that hen dip snuff, that bitty can't do it, but it was dirty and stuff. Come on down to my low cabin. Ain't about that with me, I mean. Ain't about that with me.
No one in front of us. Everyone behind us. We were the first in line.